up. Shot, I told you about Colin's phone, man.
I just had to put up in the penthouse like a jackpot. Same young niggas serving junkies at the Greg spot. Take some well-known pussy, eat it till she pass out. Take a strip of smoke, some Keisha with it, then cash out.
Y'all, I told Bailey, I said, don't pee inside this house, don't poop inside this house, don't pee, don't poop, don't pee, don't poop, don't pee, don't poop, don't pee, don't poop. Y'all wanna know what this freaking knucklehead does? He freaking pees as soon as I open the front door. I'm like, Bailey! Remember when I said that to you? And you look back and what you do? Mm-hmm. He freaking smiled like it was something cute. So, everyone see Bailey's face. And say time out Bailey. Time out Bailey. But I can't even put him in timeout. I probably won't even put him in timeout by the time I get back. Because I'm giving him some freedom and letting him stay out and about while like whenever me and Jeremy are at the house. Because the first place I never let him out while I was gone. Simply because he was a puppy and he made a lot of accidents and I had a roommate, so I wasn't trying to have him peeing all over the house. And then when I got to the second place with Tiani, I did start off by letting him out, but he quickly showed me that he could not handle that because he peed on her carpet a few times. So I had to start back putting him up. Then I got to my last place by myself, and I never really put him out because I was just apprehensive that he was going to pee all over the carpet and just make accidents, and he was still making accidents before. But now I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and let him just have fun in his freedom, and yeah. It's now my sweet boy. He's so cute. But anyways, you guys, I thought I was going to be sleeping in all day today. However, I woke up. My sister was texting me saying, was I going to go to my niece's award ceremony? And her mom, is my list yet? Her mom did call me, or text me rather, and asked me, well, not asked, but she said, hey, my niece having awards tomorrow. I don't know what I read last night, but it wasn't that. So, I think I read the message like Imani already had awards and she got an award for academics instead of she has awards tomorrow for academics. So my sister, she just got back in from work. She works a night shift at the hospital, so she was a little bit tired and I really want to be there for my sweet pumpkin. So I hurried up and did some orders because Lex doesn't work on Fridays, and I try to give her Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays because she loves to be off on Sundays. I remember her when me and her first started being friends. I know she used to talk to me about like she liked having her Sundays to herself, so I made sure she can have that day. And then Fridays and Saturdays, I like having Fridays and Saturdays to myself, so I gave her those 2 days off as well. So anyways, hello, thanks for calling Got Limbs, how may I help you? Okay, yeah, you can text this number. All right, thank you, and I'm so sorry once again. All right, bye. Okay, so anyways, you guys, let me get my jacket on and get out of here. It's 12:06. Bye, sweet boy. I got my phone, my breakfast, and let me make sure, is this heater? Because since there's so much glass in this room, it takes longer to warm up, so I just have this heater since I'm gonna be in here a lot. Bye, sweet boy. Mama loves you so, so much, even though you do things like make accidents in front of the door. Okay. She may sleep all day. She may sleep all day.
She does really want to sleep. Oh, came up there.
My sister just got an award.
Congratulations. I gotta get up before.
Pumpkin, I'm so proud of you, okay?
Okay.
You got your academic award, which means you're doing what you got to do, okay?
Okay.
And your birthday is coming up soon.
Okay.
You know that? You know that?
Mm-hmm.
I love you.
I love you too.
Okay, guys, so
back in the car, lips still chap. Trying to see why my lips keep chapping up this easily, but someone said it's because of the CarMax, which I probably agree with. Pumpkin, huh? You can see yourself on the camera? Scoot over a little bit, pretty girl. There you go. Come here. Tell them what award you got. Oops. Tell them what award you got. Do you know the name of it? You forgot? Mm-hmm. You got the Academics Award. Mm-hmm. You know that? Mm-hmm. Can I have a kiss? Mm-mm. You saw your sister? She was asleep. Yeah. The whole time. So, TT is going to give you a big Chuck E. Cheese party with your friends for doing so good in school, okay?
Okay.
That's what you're going to do for your birthday. So, instead of getting a toy today, we can get lunch today, and then I can pay for your Chuck E. Cheese party, and you can choose your three best friends that was in your class that I just met, okay?
Okay.
And I'm going to get you some invitations, and I'll probably give it to your mom so she can talk to their parents and make sure they have a ride there. Because your birthday falls on a Sunday. So we'll probably do it on Saturday because I leave and go out of town. I leave and go out of town, Pumpkin. Okay, so your birthday falls on a Sunday. We'll do it on the 10th. So on the 9th, we'll bring cupcakes. Your mom says she's bringing cupcakes to the school. So she'll probably bring the invitations for your three friends, okay? And then I'll get you Chuck E. Cheese and stuff, and we'll do that. Oh, you want me to invite some of Jeremy's nieces?
Mm-hmm.
That'd be nice. You haven't got to meet them yet. You remember Jeremy? So you get to, I'll invite some of his nieces too. That's what we're gonna do. I love you so much, Pumpkin.
I love you too.
I'm just so happy for you. I'm just so happy for you. Mm. You look so beautiful, Pumpkin. You know that?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to make me cry. Because you're growing up so fast. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all, I'm literally tearing up. You're growing up so fast, Pumpkin. You know you're making TT cry?
Mm-hmm.
You want me to cry?
No.
But you're just growing up so fast. You're a big girl. I remember I was holding you in my arms. And now you're such a big girl. You don't want me to be emotional? A little bit? I love you, Pumpkin. Okay. Waiting for
my grandma and my mommy and dad.
Mm-hmm. And who else?
My baby sister.
Your baby sister. I guess they're talking to the parents. You guys, I'm literally, like, my heart is so heavy. Like, I love my niece so much. Both of my nieces.
TT?
Hmm?
I seen a rainbow outside.
You saw what? A rainbow?
Uh-huh.
When? Today?
Yeah.
You want some of this, Pumpkin?
Mm-hmm.
You can have the rest. You want me to open it? I wish I had a straw for you, but you're a big girl. Tell me if you like it. You like it? Okay, good. Okay, guys, I'm back. Maybe I shouldn't vlog, because I think my last clip was I was in the car with my niece, and here I am back again in the car. So I'll catch y'all when I get out the car and tell y'all what's going on. Okay, guys, so I'm at the mall, and y'all actually haven't seen me at the mall in a while. Like, now that Christmas is over, all the holidays are over, there's really no reason for me to be here, and I am trying to stop spending money. Little old me is trying to stop spending money, but I just threw out a lot of my shoes, so I feel like there is gonna be a reason for me to come and get something soon, but today is not that day because I'm actually at the mall to get a gift for someone. That someone being, I'm pretty sure you already guessed it, Jeremy. So, Jeremy has started his business, as you guys already know, and it is about to be launched very, very soon. There's just a few more things that he's going to need, and one of them being a computer. So since we've moved, I actually have the desktop in my room because simply it was my computer anyways. And not that, you know, I don't mind sharing, but if you go to any corporate office, y'all don't see nobody bringing computer back and forth from room to room. Like, everyone just has their own. And yeah, so Alexis works from my desktop computer every day, and there's just other things that I am doing recently. And you know, he just really needs his own computer for his business. So he told me yesterday that he has to get one, but Jeremy has been working so hard and investing so much. If you guys don't know, a business is a huge investment. With that being said, he has bought pretty much everything, and I want to personally feel like I have given him something to say, like, I believe in you, babe. This is gonna be a great move for you, and I'm really excited. So this is something, because he has to get a few more things for his room, some furniture, because y'all know I didn't have a 3-bedroom at my last place. So obviously he has to furnish his whole room from the beginning to the end, and we do want to get the apartment tour out sooner rather than later, or never, because I never got it out for the last place. So he said he wanted to get a TV, some like couches or something, or a couch, and then obviously his computer. And I decided the computer is an investment towards his business, so that's something I want to be able to contribute. He has no idea. So I wanted to, well, I woke up today and I just thought about it, literally, because I'm like, oh, I would hate for him to go and pick one up and then I'm SOL. Y'all, I just met a Dunn. It's free. Got the freaking thing. This thing heavy as hell. But anyways, I just met a Dunn. Guys are so like blunt, and they act the most normal when they meet you. He's like, hey, aren't you Keisha? You're on YouTube, right? Hey, what's up? And then like walked off. Girls are always like so shy, or what they'll do is they'll see me and then snap me right after and say, hey, I just saw you. The funny part about it is, most of the time, I know exactly who it was, because every time they see me, like, they'll stop and they'll look, but I'm never gonna just go up to someone and say, hey, do you know me? Like, that's weird as crap. Okay guys, so I just made it back home. I'm in the parking garage now. So what I'm about to do is I'm gonna put my camera in my purse, and I'm going to keep it in my purse, but I'm gonna walk in and hopefully he's here. I don't think he left, but anyways, I'm gonna get his reaction. Y'all won't see it, but y'all will hear it. So yeah, so let's go ahead. I'm gonna have to make 2 trips because once again, I can't carry all this stuff, so that's not gonna work. Okay guys, so since I'm a sap, I decided to do it a little bit differently. I put the computer on his desk, and I wrote a long note telling him how I really am happy for him jump-starting his business, and just all this lovey-dovey stuff about how much I support him, how much I care, and then what having a business really means, and just a couple of words to just remember within the process of him having his business and all the other good stuff. So I can't show y'all the setup because all of his other, y'all can still see the redness of my skin a little bit. But anyways, I can't show y'all the setup because he has all of his other business stuff literally all over the place. So yeah, and since it's already there, I don't know when he's gonna walk through the door, so there's no way for me to like prop a camera up. So I guess I just have to just ask him after it's all said and done. Hey guys, so I just don't understand some people sometimes. I just don't understand it. So y'all remember when I'm smacking a little bit, I got gum. And if y'all don't know, if you have braces, you're not supposed to have gum, because literally the gum gets stuck on your brace as it is right now. So I'm constantly smacking to take my tongue and flip the gum off of it. No, that's annoying. But anyway, so tell me why I'm over here laying down, minding my business. I start going through all my emails because it's so freaking many. And my manager at my property, she emailed me yesterday, or a few days ago rather, and she was like, hey, did such and such refer you or something like that, she was saying. And I saw my moving company's name, but then she put another name beside it. And I'm like, I don't know what she's talking about. What is she specifically asking me? And I don't even recognize that name. So I emailed her back last night and I was like, hey, what are you asking? And she just emailed me back and said that my moving company said that they referred me to live here. And since I moved in, I need to confirm whether or not this is true so that they can get a referral credit. How the heck you gonna sit here and just lie like that? How you gonna sit here and lie like that? Because the way I remember the conversation when I reached out to my movers after we had already decided we were moving here, that's why I needed movers. So when I contacted three different moving companies to get price quotes, the first one, which was the one I used, called me back first the next morning. And when he asked where I was, like, where is your destination spot? And I told him, and I was like, because every time I talk about my address, people are like, huh? So when I told him, I was trying to explain it to him. He's like, oh, no, I know exactly where that's at because my homeboy lives there. And I was like, oh, really? He's like, yeah. He lives on the very top floor, blah, blah, blah. We was there for New Year's and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, oh, okay, cool. So then he proceeds to send me some pictures. I'm like, okay. So then he proceeds to also ask me to help him to edit some YouTube videos and upload some YouTube videos. And then that's where he missed me. I don't need no discounts or handouts in life by helping people with their YouTube stuff, like, period. Like, I'd rather pay full price because I'm not sitting there, like, I don't know why people feel as though just because I have knowledge of how to do YouTube or how to work YouTube or even how to run a business means that, oh, you're gonna just voluntarily give me that service to help you out with that and give me a discount. So he gave me a price, and I don't know what the original price is because at that moment that was my first time ever reaching out to a moving company. And then that was that, y'all. This gum is stuck all the way in my teeth. Oh my gosh, I gotta get all this stuff out now. But anyways, so y'all had ignored it, and the day when he was done, he had called me back about it again. And I'm like, sir, if you gave me a discount, that was on you. I didn't say, hey, I can help you do this such and such with YouTube, and then you can upload my and then you can give me a discount for this, because no, I would have just paid the regular full price, whatever you took off for that. But now you sit here calling my manager talking about you told me to move here so you can get the, and I'm confused because you don't even live here. You're freaking homeboy. You know what? That's whose freaking name it probably is on that email. Because I know for a fact that's not that guy's name. I'm not the best with names. I used to be so good with names, but I just have so many coming into my life these days. But anyways, I know his name when I see it. And that definitely was not his name. So I think happened was he probably gave his buddy, and that's probably what he was calling me. See, everything is coming together. He probably told his buddy, hey, we're going to say that I know this YouTube girl who lives in your building, and we're going to say that you was her referral and you just split the money with me. Because you, I think you get like $1,000 for referring somebody. So we're going to split the money. Boom, boom, boom. You done lost it. You done lost it. Because business is business. Don't voluntarily have me thinking that you're going to be doing something for me because I'm going to do something in return for you that I never agreed to. Because at the end of the day, if you really want to know how to upload a video, you will Google it. People just don't want stuff bad enough these days that now she, like, I just moved here. Now she's going to be looking at me like, what? And now she probably confused this crap just as much as I'm confused. So now I got to pay her a nice little visit on Monday.
Baby's back. He went in my room, and I'm pretty sure he's gonna see my computer back in my room, but he hasn't went in his room yet. I'm trying to sneak and vlog.
He is so mean. Okay, guys, so I don't have to cook dinner anymore because babe, so we're about to go to dinner.
I'll call you in the morning, okay? I don't know yet.
I gotta put my shoes on. Y'all won't go this freaking room. Oh, I see where I see now. Oh, that looks cute. Oh yeah, I like it right there. Okay, guys. Babe is vlogging his version and I'm vlogging my version. We're weird. Let's see who got the best clip. You guys, we got lobster spring rolls. And I tried to be experimental and I got some raw fish. I forgot what the name of this bowl is called. Y'all, it's so freaking dark in here. Hold on, let me try to get some light. Okay, there we go. So it's raw salmon, raw tuna, raw, what's the other part? Raw salmon, tuna, yellowtail, and raw shrimp over rice and cucumbers and avocado. It's good overall. It's just I can't freaking eat it with all these, with how to work this chopstick. I've never learned, so this is how I'm picking it up. A little bit, a little bit. So I'm leaving from getting my microneedling. My face is still numb. It's crap. And I apologize if y'all see